Sutra on Perfect Wisdom, with the divisions of the Abhishamayalamkara, translated by Edward Conze, University of California Press, Berkeley, Los Angeles, London. Translation of the Sutra, Chapter 40, Mara, Faults, Attainment with Great Difficulty. Subhuti. The Lord has proclaimed these virtues of those sons and daughters of good family who have set out for the supreme enlightenment, and who will course in the six perfections, mature beings, and purify the Buddha fields. Which obstacles will, on the other hand, arise to them? The Lord. Only after a long time will they understand this perfection of wisdom. This should be known as Mara's deed to the bodhisattvas. Subhuti. For what reason will they understand only after a long time? The Lord. Here the bodhisattva, who courses in perfect wisdom, will very laboriously fulfill the perfection of wisdom, and the other perfections. In this way he will understand only after a long time. Sudden flashes of ideas arise too quickly. Moreover, sudden flashes of ideas will arise too quickly. This also should be known as Mara's deed to the bodhisattvas. Subhuti. In what way does to the bodhisattvas a deed of Mara arise from the sudden spread of their flashes of insight? The Lord. Here to a bodhisattva who courses in the six perfections, but who is without the wholesome root of skill in means, sudden flashes of ideas arise too quickly. Threefold unsuitable bodily behavior. Moreover, they will copy out this perfection of wisdom while yawning, while laughing, and while sneering at one another. Threefold unsuitable mental behavior. Moreover, they will copy it out with their thoughts disturbed. They will copy it out with their minds on other things. Or it will occur to these bodhisattva that we do not derive any enjoyment from this, and with these words they will get up from their seats and take their leave. Recitation for the wrong reasons. Furthermore, they will yawn, get up from their seats, and take their leave. Or, yawning, they will study, bear in mind, recite, demonstrate, and attend. Or, laughing at one another, they will learn, bear in mind, recite, study, and wisely attend. Or, sneering at one another, they will write, learn to wisely attend. Or, with thoughts disturbed, they will learn, or they will learn, with their minds on other kinds of talk. Consideration of reasons for rejecting the sutra. Subhuti. As the Lord has said, we do not derive any enjoyment from this. With these words, they will get up from their seats and take their leave. This also should be known as Mara's deed to the bodhisattvas. For what reason do they not derive any enjoyment from this? The Lord. Because in the past also they have not coursed in the six perfections. Furthermore, it is another deed of Mara that it occurs to the bodhisattvas that they are not predestined for this perfection of wisdom. And so, their thoughts devoid of serene faith, they will get up from their seats and leave. Subhuti. For what reason do they feel that they are not predestined for the perfection of wisdom? The Lord. Bodhisattvas who have not definitely set out on their career of a bodhisattva are certainly not predicted to the supreme enlightenment, and they have no serene faith in this perfection of wisdom because their name is not mentioned in it. Subhuti. For what reason are the names of bodhisattvas not proclaimed in this deep perfection of wisdom? The Lord. Certainly the names of unpredicted bodhisattvas are not proclaimed. They think to themselves that my name is here not proclaimed, nor that of the village, city, marketplace, royal city, or nation where I was born, and then decide that the perfection of wisdom is not worthwhile their listening to and that they had better leave that assembly. And each time they decide to leave, they get away from the Buddha Dharmas. As often as they have the thought of leaving, for so many eons they will have to take to birth and death and make new efforts again and again. Desertion of the cause of Buddhahood. There. Prajna Paramita. Having spurned the perfection of wisdom which nourishes the cognition of the all-knowing, they will seek and search for those sutras which do not nourish it. In this way those sons and daughters of good family will decide to spurn the root of the attainment of the cognition of all knowledge, and to look instead for support in what are mere branches, leaves, and foliage. Subhuti. Which are the sutras that do not nourish the cognition of the all-knowing and which they decide to study? The Lord. They are the sutras associated with the vehicle of the disciples and pratyekabuddhas. They enjoin the application of mindfulness, the right efforts, to the doors to deliverance which consists in emptiness, the signless, the wishless. When they have stood in these, the sons and daughters of good family attain the fruit a stream winner, to the enlightenment of a pratyekabuddha. These are the sutras associated with the level of the disciples and pratyekabuddhas which are conducive to nourishing the vehicle of all knowledge, and which those people decide to study after they have spurned the perfection of wisdom. And why? For the bodhisattvas have issued from the perfection of wisdom, and when they train in perfect wisdom they will go forth to the worldly and supramundane spiritual dharmas and train in them. Loss of taste for this most sublime teaching. Just as a dog would spurn a morsel of food or a sip of water from a servant, just so, in the future, some persons belonging to the great vehicle will spurn this deep perfection of wisdom which is the root of all the Buddha dharmas, and decide instead to study the sutras associated with the vehicles of the disciples and pratyekabuddhas, sutras which are like branches, leaves, and foliage. This also will be Mara's deed to them. Furthermore, there will be in the future some adherents of the bodhisattva vehicle who, having spurned this deep perfection of wisdom, will decide to study the sutras associated with the vehicle of the disciples and pratyekabuddhas for the sake of gain and honor. Desertion of the supreme vehicle. If a man who wants an elephant were to get hold of one and then be content to examine his foot, would that man be an intelligent person? Subhuti. No, Lord. The Lord. The same is true of those persons who belong to the bodhisattva vehicle and who, having spurned this deep perfection of wisdom, decide to study the sutras associated with the vehicles of the disciples and pratyekabuddhas. What do you think, Subhuti? Would these followers of the great vehicle be very intelligent? Subhuti. No, Lord. The Lord. This also should be known as Mara's deed to the bodhisattvas. Desertion of the highest goal. Just as a person would want to see the great ocean, on having seen it he would look for a puddle in a cow's footprint. On having seen that he would say to himself that it is of the same size as the great ocean. What do you think, Subhuti? Would that be a very intelligent person? Subhuti. No, Lord. The Lord. The same is true of the followers of the great vehicle who, after they have heard and obtained this perfection of wisdom, abandon it to learn the sutras associated with the disciples and pratyekabuddhas. What do you think, Subhuti? Would they be very intelligent people? Subhuti. No, Lord. The Lord. This also should be known as Mara's deed to the bodhisattvas. Desertion of both the cause of Buddhahood and the fruit connected with it. Just as a mason or mason's apprentice would want to build a palace of the size of the Vaidyanta palace and would take his measure from the size of the sun and moon, would that be an intelligent thing to do? Subhuti. No, Lord. The Lord. Just so there will be in the future some followers of the bodhisattva vehicle who, after they have heard and obtained this deep perfection of wisdom, will spurn and reject it and will decide to search for the knowledge of all modes in the sutras associated with the disciples and pratyekabuddhas. Would these people be very intelligent? Subhuti. No, Lord. The Lord. This also should be known as Mara's deed to bodhisattvas. Desertion of the highest possible form of existence. Suppose some person sees the commander of a fort and thinks to himself that he is like the universal monarch in his complexion and shape. Having observed the aspects, signs, and tokens of the complexion and shape of the commander of a fort, he would say that these are the distinctive aspects of the complexion and shape of the universal monarch. What do you think, Subhuti? Would that be an intelligent person? Subhuti. No, Lord. The Lord. Just so there will be in the future some followers of the great vehicle who, after they have heard and obtained this deep perfection of wisdom, will spurn and reject it and will decide to search for the knowledge of all modes in the sutras associated with the disciples and pratyekabuddhas. Would these people be very intelligent? Subhuti. No, Lord. The Lord. This also should be known as Mara's deed to the bodhisattvas. 13. the production of many flashes of ideas, and of distracting thoughts directed towards a great variety of objects. Moreover, to those sons and daughters of good family who copy out this perfection of wisdom, many flashes of ideas will arise, which will disturb their writing of this deep perfection of wisdom. These flashes of ideas will concern sight objects, sounds too, Buddha Dharmas and the Supreme Enlightenment. And why? For the perfection of wisdom is without flashes or ideas, it is unthinkable and inconceivable. It is not produced or stopped, not defiled or purified. It cannot be disturbed, it is inexpressible, it is without basis. And why? Because in this deep perfection of wisdom those dharmas do not exist. If some follower of the bodhisattva vehicle is disturbed by these dharmas when they hear or copy out this deep perfection of wisdom, then that also is Mara's deed to him. 14. One settles down in the idea that this text is copied out. Subhuti. Is it then possible to write down the perfection of wisdom? The Lord. No, Subhuti. And why? Because the own being of the perfection of wisdom does not exist, nor that of the other perfections, the emptinesses, the Buddha Dharmas or all knowledge. That of which the own being does not exist, that is non-existence. What is non-existence cannot be written down by the non-existent. 15. One settles down in the idea that it is non-existence. Note. Differs from printed RR. F. Again, some followers of the great vehicle have the notion that this perfection of wisdom is a non-existent. This also will be an act of the evil one. 16. One adheres to it as in the letters. Subhuti. If some followers of the great vehicle, after they have copied out this deep perfection of wisdom in written letters, should think that the deep perfection of wisdom has been written down by me, then they form an attachment to the written letters as representing the deep perfection of wisdom. This also should be known as Mara's deed to them. 17. One adheres to it as not in the letters. And why? Because this perfection of wisdom is not in the letters, nor are the other perfections too. All knowledge. But if followers of the great vehicle settle down in the perfection of wisdom, as not in the letters, then that also should be known as Mara's deed to them. 18. Attention to worldly objects, such as a pleasant countryside. Moreover, when these sons and daughters of good family copy out this perfection of wisdom, their minds will be on the landscape. This also should be known as Mara's deed to them. Furthermore, they will pay attention to villages, cities, market towns, royal cities, nations, gods, and teachers. Their attentions will be associated with mother, father, brother, sister, son, daughter, and relatives, with robbers and outcasts, with discoursings about sense pleasures, with the company of others, and many other things. In this way, also Mara, the evil one, will arrange obstacles and disturbances to those who copy out this deep perfection of wisdom, expound and repeat it, wisely attend to it. 19. A taste for gain, honor, and fame. Furthermore, they will relish the thought of gain, honor, and fame, be concerned about their robes, arms, bowl, lodging, and medicinal appliances for use in sickness. This also is Mara's deed to them. 20. One seeks for skill in means where it cannot be found. Furthermore, Mara, the evil one, will bring along very deep sutras to the bodhisattvas who copy out this deep perfection of wisdom, expound and repeat it, and wisely attend to it. But bodhisattvas who are skilled in means should not long for those very deep sutras which Mara has brought along. And why? Because they do not nourish all knowledge. But bodhisattvas, who have no skill in means, will, after they have heard it, reject this deep perfection of wisdom in which I have extensively found that these followers of the great vehicle should, having rejected this deep perfection of wisdom, seek for skill in means in those sutras associated with the vehicle of the disciples and pratyekabuddhas, that also should be known as Mara's deed. End chapter 40.